In one of my previous videos, I tested how much LA adhesion we're losing by printing PLA filaments at higher flow rates and how even a different color can dictate your maximum printing speeds. As quite a few of you have been asking to test other types of materials, today we're going to find out not only how LA adhesion compares between PLA, PETG and ASA filaments, but also how much strength we're losing by not keeping our filaments dry. To test the difference between wet and dry filaments, I chose a realistic scenario where we take a new filament out of a box and keep it in a 50-60% relative humidity environment for 3 days. Then make test prints, dry the filaments and repeat the prints. The filaments that I will be testing today are the Bambu Labs Basic PLA, PETG High Flow and ASA. I asked them for these specific filaments as it will be interesting to see how their new high flow PETG stacks against others. But I will also include results of a generic PETG to understand if high flow is just marketing or if it actually performs better. The printer I will be testing these filaments on is the SK1, which I upgraded with BigTerTech parts. It rocks BTT Pi 2 and the top of a line Kraken board, which can power the stepper motors up to 60 volts and has 7 fan ports that you can run at different voltages just by placing a jumper. As this printer will be more like a testing platform, I designed a custom printhead bracket which was manufactured by today's video sponsor PCBWay. It will allow me to quickly make custom adapters for mounting and testing extruders, hot ends and more. So if you need professionally manufactured parts, make sure to check all the things PCBWay has to offer, especially as they extended their 10th anniversary celebration where you can get all kinds of discounts for your orders. Other important parts of this build are the printhead that has quite a unique and lightweight Artemis single drive gear extruder combined with BTT's Panda River hot end with a high flow brass nozzle. I'm using the EBB46 tool headboard over canvas and for leveling the bed I installed BTT Microprobe V2. So huge thanks to ABOS4D and especially BigTerTech for providing these upgrade parts. You can find the full list of them in the description below. The way I'm testing the LA adhesion is by running the print that has a middle section printed at different flow rates. Then I cut it into 20 testing samples for each flow rate and break them on a tensile strength testing machine. To get more comparable data between different materials, I measure the width of a sample printed 5 cubic millimeters per second flow rates and calculate adhesion strength in megapascals using those values. So with all the technicality out of the way, let's dive straight into the results. First I printed the basic PLA filament that was left for 3 days out of the box. Its LA adhesion was okay but nothing special as even by printing it slowly it didn't reach 40 MPa. After all it is basic PLA and it showed similar strength results from my previous testing. To dry the filaments I used the Sunlo S4Dry that they sent me to test. It looked quite good at first but I very quickly ran into a serious concerns when I took a closer look with a thermal camera. Basically because the hot air from a heater element is blown directly at the filaments, it results in the hotspot that is significantly higher than the set temperature. I later even checked the temperature with a thermocouple and it showed even more concerning findings. Because of that, I had to dry filaments at a lower set temperature and rotate it by 90 degrees. Later I solved this issue just by designing and making some heat shields. So thus fully drying PLA filament and printing it from a dry box without actively heating it results in higher strength? Well, I couldn't see any difference in LA adhesion whatsoever. The strength variance was too small and not consistent enough to call it any other way. These results align with my experience with regular PLA filaments as I rarely dry them and I never note significantly weaker parts. But I also don't keep my filaments exposed like for some reason others do and all my filaments go back into the original packaging. Plus the ones I test often always have silica gel beads inside. Next is Bambu Labs newly released high flow PETG. Usually a regular PETG filament doesn't like to be printed fast as it needs to be heated very well to maintain its mechanical properties. But the Bambu high flow variant that was left to soak moisture for 3 days performed basically like their PLA. It was great to see that it achieved such a small strength drop off at higher flow rates, but the overall LA adhesion was poor considering that this is PETG. We usually choose this type of material to print more durable parts as high LA adhesion combined with flexibility goes really well hand in hand. However, they clearly stated that this filament must be dried before use. This was quite obvious during the printing, especially at higher speeds as prints had many tiny bubbles. What is happening here is the absorbed moisture boiling and popping during extrusion. The view under microscope was even better. Not only we can see all the bubbles popped but also how uneven the layer lines were. Fully drying the high flow PETG and printing it from a dry box with no active heating resulted in substantially better lay adhesion. In fact, the results were kind of mind-blowing. Drying the filament not only yielded 22% higher lay adhesion than printing at 5 cubic millimeter per second flow rate, but it increased up to 48% at the 20 cubic millimeter per second flow rate mark. For a comparison, I also printed with a generic PETG. While it managed to outperform the Bambu high flow variant at low printing speeds, it shrunk at higher speeds, dropped like a rock, and it even couldn't reach 20 cubic millimeter per second printing speed with this high flow Panda Revo hot end. But the worst part with this generic PETG is that it loses all its mechanical properties when printed too fast and becomes brittle and crunchy. That is definitely the last thing we want from a material that is supposed to make durable prints. Moving forward, we have a Bambu Labs ASA filament. I was hoping that it would be enough to wrap the printer with a packing tape, but unfortunately it was not. So to properly test this type of filament, I quickly made a box from a box. This time I also used a different kind of glue stick, and each time I started the print, I ensured the enclosure temperature would be the same. However, the test prints with a wet ASA filament had the lower lay adhesion so far. The most interesting part was how little the strength dropped at higher flow rates. But the only question is, can we improve this low lay adhesion by drying the filament? And the answer is yes. It didn't improve as much as with high flow PETG, but it still yielded a significant increase of 15% on average. An interesting point is that ASA filament still maintained a similar strength as PLA when printed at 20 cubic millimeter per second speed. But the main reason for that is most likely because of a shorter time for the previous layer to cool off, and because ABS and ASA filaments love to be hot to bond better, as Stefan from CNC Kitchen already showed. With that information, it is safe to say that your lay adhesion results with ABS and ASA filaments probably be higher, as my Jank enclosure only maintain around 40 degrees Celsius temperature. All these results confirm what I experienced with these three different material types. PLA is most forgiving filament, as even leaving it for days in the open most likely won't result in weaker prints. But this only applies to regular PLA filaments and not carbon, glass or wood filled ones. Meanwhile, Bambu Labs high flow PETG dominated the lay adhesion chart and showed what high flow should truly mean. The only caveat is that you must try it and print it from a dry box for the best results. Otherwise, its performance lay adhesion wise will only be comparable to the basic PLA, and prints will have many tiny bubbles all over them. But just keep in mind that nothing comes without a cost, and with Bambu high flow PETG will be losing temperature resistance compared to their discontinued basic PETG. Those temperatures come even closer to the basic PLA, so just keep that in mind when choosing the right filament for your print. Lastly, the SA. This one is the most heat resistant of these three, but it's also hardest to print just because you want a high chamber temperature for the best lay adhesion results. In my case, with a 40 degrees Celsius temperature, it didn't provide good enough lay adhesion for my liking, but your results will vary. Plus, it also requires you to dry the filament and maintain it that way for the best results. So as you see, these tested filaments are quite different, so make sure to choose correctly for your prints and what you want to achieve. In the future, I will be testing more types of filaments, so make sure to subscribe and don't forget to like the video. Huge thanks to all the people who support my work on Patreon and YouTube. These tests take a lot of time and effort to make, so don't be a stranger and consider joining along these amazing people. Well, that's all from me, and I'll see you next time.